Hello sir, my topic is clicker system optimization. So during today presentation, I'm going to represent what is a clicker, what make it unique, implication for its teaching and learning, and the type of data collected, and what are the downside of clickers. Next we will go through the literature view, which is supposed to be covered the student response system, clicker response system, audience response system, and etc., which is related to the clicker fields. And after that we are going to discuss the clicker development in IIT Bombay. And next I will discuss about the motivation about the project, and then the problem statement which I analyze and assume due to the literature survey. And after that, what is the future work we can cover about the clicker. Okay, so first is, what is clicker? So clicker basically is a learning aid, or we can say a interface which provide the better understanding of a course material. So like previously, before the clicker development, if in a large class or even in a small class, if student want to ask any question, but he stop asking question because of some kind of fear in a large class. So to enhance the communication between the instructor and the student, clickers provide the mechanism so that the student can ask questions regardless of the verbal communication. So how it could be possible? So clicker provide an hardware device by which there are some options, like if instructor asks some questions, so that question will be displayed on a projector, and all the student, they have some hardware on so on their hardware there is an option for selecting the answer. When the student select an options, that options are collected on the instructor computer using some interface which is connected to the clicker of an instructor to the computer. Okay. So basically clicker use infrared or a radio frequency for communication. Okay. So the main purpose of clicker is that the student should understand the fundamental concepts of a course, and also to allow the active participation by all student. And how, like as I already said, when student give their responses, all the responses are collected back to the instructor, so instructor can tabulate all the responses. According to that, student can analyze on which questions he have to give some more suggestions, or he have to again recollect thoughts. So next question is, what make it unique? So one point is that whatever the size of the class, the instructor is always able to gauge the student's standing with the help of responses the student have sent on the instructor computer. Also the result from the class responses can be saved and displayed in a variety of formats like histograms, pie charts, etc. Okay. The next point is, what are the implications for teaching and learning of a clicker? The first implication is, we can say, like interaction and engagement, both important learning principle, as when there is a more engagement, then the active participation in class improve, and the student learning and the individual growth of a student increase. So next question is about the about what type of question should be asked in a class. Like if the question is wrong, then the understanding of a student will not improve to the point which have to be. Like if the question is very tough, then student will not be able to answer that question. So the question should be asked in a way that it is related to the deep, it is related to the deep theoretical knowledge of the concepts. So choosing the right question is very important. Next is, after the responses are collected, which response should teacher correspond? It is also a main important point to selecting a question. Next, the type of data collected in Clicker. So there are a variety of data types which we can use, like if teacher want to conduct a quiz, what type of data he can ask, like he can ask survey, he can ask for any questionnaire, quizzes, and some type of field notes, observations. A lot of data related to this field can be asked using a Clicker. Okay, basically in the most of the universities, the main form of data collection is basically quizzes and surveying. During the exams also, the teacher asks multiple choice of questions. The main question arises, what are the downsides of a clickers? So the first drawback is a cost factor in hardware clickers. Earlier there was clickers which are composed of some hardware component. So the cost of that hardware is not very expensive if the class is very large. So the reduce the cost factor. So nowadays we are proposing the clickers which is based on the Android system, which are related to the, like we can use tablet, cell phones or a PDA for getting a question and responding to the questions. So the next downside of a clicker could be like if we use like portable devices like tablets, smartphones or a laptop, then it could be possible that like for these devices an internet connection is needed during the communication between the instructor and student. So for that communication, as internet facility will be available during the class, so student can distract from the course. Like if the internet facility available, then he can leap over the other uses of a internet, like browsing something else. So it could be a downside of a clicker. So we can provide some mechanism to not allow this kind of habits, like if we can down the server, like if we ask question, then we can down the server while student will give the response. When student will ready to give the response, then we can again up the server. Okay, the next downside of a clicker is like if SMS based clicker response system is used. So what is basically this SMS based clicker response system? Like through the some SMS gateway, student can send the responses. So the major drawback is of this system is that cost factor, because SMS costs some rupee. So we can remove this thing by using some type of SMS gateway system by which we can send SMS freely. Okay. The next slide is represent the literature review I have covered throughout my MTech stage 1 project. So I have covered basically what type of web-based response systems, like in 2006, Roy P. August described a web-based tool which is namely as message grid. Through that message grid, student can log in into the browser and then open the message grid and send their responses or queries and about the doubts also. So the later on in 2013, Monica represented the also same type of browser, but it is not based on the message grid. It is basically mobile clicker which was developed over a package Zowiki. So Zowiki is basically a framework which provides the facility to create quizzes, questionnaires and etc field related to this kinds of data. So it also provides a good mechanism, like it can provide different content to different kind of a student at different time. Like if one student getting a question number A, then other question, the student nearby sitting to him or her can get a question different from him or her. So due to this, we can this type of concept can be used when we are conducting exam or quizzes. So the student will not be able to cheat during the exams. Okay. The next type of literature is related to the SMS based response system. So in 2007, USPO represented an text to learn type of response system, which is basically on the SMS based classroom interaction. So what is the advantage of this kind of system? The main advantage of this kind of system is it doesn't have any cost factor. Like if we are not using any other hardware, so it will remove the hardware cost, also the installation cost. And then there are the system which are not based on any hardware, like which are device free personal response system. So what are these device free personal response system? Basically these are the system which are based on the computer vision technology, it was also implemented in India. So what is basically this device free personal response system is that the student hold some sheet. The cost of sheet is negligible. On that sheet there are some data is printed. Okay, so when the student hold the sheet, like he can hold the sheet like left, down, up and right. So these are the option. Like if we hold the sheet left, then the option is B. If hold the sheet right, then option is C. Like that there are four different options available for the student, and nearby the student in front of the all the class there is some cameras, high resolution camera are there which capture the sheets as the holded by the student. Okay, so there are some drawback associated with this system is that, like one is the cost factor. What is the cost factor? Like we needed the high resolution cameras. If we use low resolution camera, then due to the low light, sometime camera will not be able to capture all the responses by the student. So it is a major drawback of this system. Okay. So there are new response systems are developed which basically focused on the teaching programming languages. So for teaching a programming language, we need new data types. Like if teacher gives some type of coding question, so we need to answer the question in a subjective manner. So there is a new data type is needed for this kind of questions. So the Matthew in 2009 implemented a software clickers which are used for teaching Java. The same type of tools was implemented by Daniel in 2013, which describe the use of web-based response system for teaching Python. Okay, so after this literature survey, I come up with some type of observations, like what type of response, like either group or individual or both, affect the active learning. So in a class, if we ask question individually to all the student, then sometimes student is not able to understand the question easily or the concept easily. So or if we ask the question which is based on group, like we can make a group of two or three people, so that, and we put question to the individual groups, so in each group the people and the student who are the part of the group can discuss among themselves and answer the responses. So it is also a good choice when the students are not very intellectual in studies. So the clicker response system should be depend upon the choice of questions or responses. So next observation is that what type of question to be select for asking. Like if the as I already discussed about the importance of a question selection is a major role in a clicker system. Like if we ask a wrong question, then the student will not able to be analyze the question or correspond to the question. So asking a right question play an important role. Okay. And the next observation is that as we know, basically there are two fields related to clicker system. Like one is pedagogical theory and next one is implementation study. Like in pedagogical theory, we relate this theory related to the type of question asked, what type of hardware should be used. Like all these things are related to the pedagogical theory, like we should use web-based response system, all that. And the implementation study related to the how the data will be collected, how the responses will be collected, and then the feedback will be given to the student. So our study recognized that whether we should think about pedagogical theory more or implementation study. The next observation is that asking the question, like when to ask a question in the lecture, or how to maintain the pace of a lecture while asking a question. This is also major role. Like if a teacher asks question and student are not able to answer that question within a specified given point, so it will create some problem. Like, so the question should be asked in a manner that the pace of a lecture will not be affected. Okay. So the next thing I notice that if we provide some more discussion about the topic before the class, so the student will be able to analyze the concept more easily rather than facing the topic on the spot during the lecture. So before class discussion improve the positive responses of a student. Okay, so next I'm going to discuss about the clicker development at IIT Bombay. So the first clicker was developed in IIT Bombay in 2009. The first version of that clicker is consist of two hardware components, one at the instructor side and one at the student side. But the major drawback of this system is cost factor. The early version, like version 1 of this clicker, the cost of this version is around 600 rupees, and the next version which was developed, the version 2, the cost of that system was around 1100. So the major drawback of this system was the cost factor. After that, clicker was implemented in a distance education purpose. Like if we have a multiple remote classes and we want to connect all these classes through the clicker system, so that we large set of class can be benefited from the lecture. So for this purpose Divya Tiwari in 2010 represented an synchronous distributive approach for CRS. What is this synchronous distributed approach for CRS? Is that it generally implement a clicker system in a distributed manner, so that all the remote server which are set up in the different classes across the country can be benefited from the course or where the central survey is gauging the current class. So basically it involved two server. One is current server and a multiple remote server. The current server where the lecture is going on, and the multiple server which are connected to this central server. Okay. So what is the main idea behind this? The main idea is that it uses an XML file which contain all the responses of a student from the remote server. At remote server, when the instructor at the central server asks some question, then the then the controller at the server remote server side collect all the responses from the students, and these responses are collected in an XML file, and this XML file then again sent to the central server, so that the instructor can analyze the question and then analyze the responses and tabulate them and prepare the histogram of that. Okay, then again he can reply to the all the questions, which all the responses which are needed to be taught again. Okay, the next is that okay, so how the data collected as is then transferred back to the central server? It is possible because of the FTP server. Okay, the next, in IIT Bombay we implemented a web-based clicker system for Akash tablet. Before that, in IIT Bombay we are using the hardware clicker, so to remove that cost factor we implemented the web-based clicker system which are based on the Akash tablets, so that removing the cost factor. So what are the basic different modules of that Akash clicker? In that one module is called admin. This module provides the facility to add, edit, patch or delete the information regarding the student or regarding the quizzes. Okay, the main feature or the new feature which is added in this clicker system was raise hand. Like if student have some doubts, so student can ask question directly with the help of this Akash tab or Akash clicker. So this raise hand provide the good way so that student can ask the questions or a doubt in a class, or teacher can or a teacher or instructor can reply to this questions or doubt in a class or in a class during the class or after the class also. Okay, now next module is a polling, which is used to conduct a questionnaire about the how the questionnaire which contain the information regarding the student feedbacks about the lecture. The next module is a question bank. The question bank provide the facility for adding and searching a question which is for conducting exams or quizzes. So we can say question bank is our database component, which contain all the questions and the responses which are collected after the student send. Okay, the next component is for creating a quiz. It provides a facility for creating a quiz and fetching the question from the question bank. Okay, so what are the limitations of Akash clicker, or what we can say, what are limitations or constraints in Akash clicker? One is that it lack in vocabulary of a scientific symbol. If you want to ask some numerical question which contain more scientific symbols, it is difficult to ask such type of question. And so and the next thing is that it required an internet browser to fetch the clicker web application through URL. So if internet connection is not available, so this kind of system is limited for the response system which is based on the internet facility. Next, we can say constraint is that it works best in latest version of Mozilla Firefox and Google Chrome. It not work in Internet Explorer or the previous versions of web browsers. Okay. Also, it is used for a real-time responses. If we want a responses, like if a student ask question outside the class, or instructor want to give reply to that answer outside the class, so it is not possible for that purpose. So it is basically supposed to support only a real-time response. Okay. So after this literature survey and about the web based browsers and other kind of clicker response system, and the study related to the clicker implemented in IIT Bombay. I come up with some motivation. So my motivation is focus on the clicker system that can provide the more efficient way of communication between student and instructor, so that which can remove the cost factors, which can remove the cost factor and improve learning using asking some good kind of questions, or when some question is asked. So if we conduct exams, okay, so same type of question is asked to all the student. So how can we rely on the reliant student that he will not cheat during the exams, as the same question is asked for every student? Or this is the prime source of motivation. Like other source of motivation is that if teacher conduct exam, so during the exam if some students solve the question early and some student are not able to solve the question early, so there is a time slot. If student are not able to solve that question, so there is a time gap between the early response and the late response. So how can we utilize that response so that a student who solved problem early can not be reflected? So this kind of discussion is a prime source of my motivation. Also there is some drawback. Like if we ask question in a large class, so in a large class if we are using single access point, so it will create some problem of connection failure. Or even we use multiple access points, so load balancing of that access point is also a major source of my motivation. Okay. So I come up with some points. Like can we provide an interface which can generate different content to different students so the student will not cheat during the exam? Or can we enhance current clicker system so that active learning can be improved? What is mean by this statement is that can we give more type of data formats? Like can we provide the data like by which a student can give responses in terms of subjective manner? Like if we can ask question which is related to coding, syntax, so, or can we maintain the time gap between the early response or late response? So how can we implement this kind of theories? Like, or the last question is that can clicker support large class? If the clicker support large class, then how can we manage that class? Like if we ask single access, as I already discussed, if we ask for single access point, how can we remove the drawback of connection failure? Okay. So my problem statement is that how can we solve the problem of gap utilization when one student solve quiz early and other not? It is possible using a solve and evaluate approach. What is this approach is like if some students solve problem early, so the student who solve problem early can evaluate the answers of the other students. Okay, so this approach was implemented by Mathias in 2009. So we can implement this approach. Okay, the next thing is that how can we generate different content to different kind of user? So this is possible using application which was developed by Newman 2017. It is basically based on the ZooWiki content flow. What is that? It is a framework which provides the different content to different kind of user at the same time or at different time. So next Next problem is of connection failure. How can we tackle with this kind of problem? If we ask a single access point, then managing Wi-Fi connection is big hurdle. Or if when we ask multiple access point, then load balancing is a big hurdle. So the load balancing, we can done the load balancing using a hiding SSID, or we can load balance using the deadline means ratio technique. Okay, so finally I come to the conclusion. The overall conclusion of my study is based on the following factors. One is the utilizing the time gap can improve learning, and by presenting different content to different kind of a student can ensure that student will not able to cheat during the exam or quizzes. And is it possible? It is possible to block the other sites or down the server while, like if we conduct quiz or exam, when student will get the question, we can block the other sites or we can down the server for that command, that time of time or that duration of a time, and then again we set up a server after when student finish with their answer and want to send the responses. Okay, or also it is possible to apply the load balancing algorithm for maintaining or managing the multiple access points. Okay, so we can provide an interface for asking and producing programming language question in class, like syntax or coding. Okay, so next we can do in future, like we can integrate tutorial into the application so that student can be able to browse the content of the source or the course material. The one thing I am thinking about is that we can implement the recommendation system for enhancing learning capability of a learner. So I'm deeply thinking about this recommendation system, like if in a class there are many students, the student IQ is different from each other. So if we ask, like if we first ask same type of question to all the student, some will not able to answer, some will able to answer. Those who are not able to answer, the system will provide other questions which are not tougher than the earlier question. Or the student who solved the question easily, we can provide the tough question to that kind of student.